diabetic retinopathy. Diabetic retinopathy disease severity scales. No apparent retinopathy. Mild non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, NPDR. Microaneurysm only. Moderate non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, more than mild NPDR, but less than severe NPDR. Severe NPDR, any of the following in the absence of proliferative diabetic retinopathy, PDR. Diffuse, traditionally greater than 20, intraretinal hemorrhages in all four quadrants, two quadrants of venous beading, or one quadrant of prominent intraretinal microvascular abnormalities, or IRMA. Proliferative diabetic retinopathy, PDR, there is neovascularization of one or more of the following: iris, angle, optic disc or elsewhere, or vitreous or preretinal hemorrhages. Diabetic macular edema may be present in any of the stages listed above. Clinically significant macular edema requires treatment and is defined as any of the following: a retinal thickening within 500 micrometers of the fovea center, heart exudate within 500 micrometers of the fovea center if associated with thickening of the adjacent retina, and retinal thickening greater than one disc area in size, part of which is within one disc diameter of the center of the fovea. Workup. Slit lamp examination with gonioscopy with careful attention for NVI and NVA, preferably before pharmacological dilations. Dilated fundus examination by using a 90 or 60 diopter of fundus contact lens with a slit lamp to rule out neovascularization and macular edema. Use indirect ophthalmoscopy to examine the retinal periphery. Fasting blood sugar level, check the blood pressure, consider OCT to evaluate for the presence and extent of macular edema. Treatment: clinical significant macular edema, focal or grid laser treatment should be considered in patients with clinically significant macular edema. Patient with diffuse or extensive macular edema, isolated subfoveal edema. Macular edema is the presence of foveal ischemia, and those with poor response to prior focal or grid laser may benefit from an intravitreal anti-VEGF. Proliferative diabetic retinopathy, pan-retinal laser photocoagulation is indicated for any one of the following high-risk characteristics: NVD, greater than 1/4 to 1/3 of the disc area in size. Follow up: diabetes without retinopathy, annual dilated examination, mild non proliferative diabetic retinopathy, dilated examination every 6 to 9 months, moderate to severe NPDR, dilated examination every 4 to 6 months, and PDR not meeting high risk criteria, dilated examination every 2 to 3 months. Diabetes and pregnancy: changes that occur during pregnancy have a high risk likelihood of postpartum regressions.